Hi everyone, in this lesson I'm going to try and cover the main parts to a song off of the new Muse album. The song's called Unnatural Selection. It's one of my favourite songs of the album so far. It's got a couple of really good guitar riffs in. It's a great one to learn. Before we get started, the song's in drop D, so you need to take a low E string and tune it down to a D. And I use my bridge pickup for the whole song, and I've got quite a lot of distortion on. Just depends what sort of amp you've got, but you want that sort of sound, not too much distortion because it's not really a metal track. So play the intro for you first and then break it down. It's mostly just steady down picking and good exercise if you haven't been playing too long. So here's the intro. Okay, so the way we play this, we've got three bars of just down picking this note here. This is the fifth fret on what's now your low D string. So you'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then on your last bar of the first four, you got. So the high note you're after is the eighth fret on the A string. So you got. You don't have to, but I'm playing those notes on the A string with an upstroke. I think it just helps you to execute them a bit cleaner. Then you play another bar of just downstrokes on the fifth fret. And then on the next bar. Much like what you do with the eighth fret, you do that but with the sixth fret on the A string. So. Okay. And then you have. Which takes you into the main riff. So this part, you got another bar of the fifth fret, and then this. So this starts with the first finger, you shift down to the third fret, and you do three, open, three, and then you have to almost roll the pressure over on your first finger. This is the way I play it anyway. To get the third fret on the other D string. And then the second finger plays the fourth fret on the D string. Okay, so you got low D, three, open, three, and then third fret and fourth fret on the D string. And then you go open D, fourth fret, and then you jump over to the D string again, fourth fret, and then fifth fret with the second finger. Okay? And that takes you into the main riff. The main riff is this. So I think it's a pretty cool riff. Again, this is all steady, downbeat sort of thing. It's pretty similar to the intro, so if you're right with that, this is pretty easy. We got. So that part. You got eight down picks on the fifth fret of the D string. And then. This part is with the little finger. 8, 5, 8. Okay. And then I move up 9 and 10. That's play with the little finger. That's the way I've chosen to play it. Okay. And then once you get to the 10th fret, you play 8, 10, 11, 11, and 12. Okay, so. So from here, 8, 10, 11, 11, 12. Okay. And then you've got some open Ds. So I'm going to play that whole section for you really, really slow. okay? After that, we go... now, this is a lot like the pattern that was at the end of the intro. Starts on the 3rd fret of the high D string. After that, you play 3 on the D string. Open D, that's the low D. 3rd fret. And then you go back to your D string and you play 3rd fret and 4th fret. So... the frets one more time, 3rd fret D string, open D, 3rd fret D string, and then 3rd fret high D string, and then the 4th fret. That pattern's basically shifted up then. So you do open D string, 4th fret, 4th fret high D string, and 5th fret. So that chunk really slowly. It sounds quite weird slow, but it's pretty natural when it's sped up. And most Muse riffs have a strange twist to them somewhere as part of their sound. So yeah, whole thing again. Then once you've done this, first finger returns to the 5th fret and the whole thing starts again. It's quite a few notes, so if you miss that you'll need to go back and just watch it a couple of times till you've got it. Next section is this one. So this is almost like the pre-chorus. Yeah, so it just gets ready for the chorus and it goes like this. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 picks on each of these notes. You've got the 3rd fret on the G string, 2nd fret, and then 2 down picks on the 3rd fret and the 5th fret. I'm playing that with my 2nd and 4th fingers. So. Then I move to the B string, 3rd fret, and 6th fret. They're both played twice. So far we got... and then you got... so... then you got 8 lots of the 4th fret on the B string. And then you have this, what sounds to me like a flat 5 sort of thing when you listen to the record. So you hold the 2nd fret on the G string and you pick that with it. And then you continue another 7 picks on the 4th fret of the B string. So that bit goes... okay, so you're just letting the notes bleed together. So the whole thing... and then you have this bit. So this bit, you got 4 picks on 3rd fret of the B string, 1st fret, and then you do the same 2 notes but only twice. So then we move to the G string. And we do 2 picks on the 3rd fret of the G string and the 2nd fret. And then you do 4 picks of the same notes. And so the whole thing is... and then you have this part.